This study really grew out of the data that we had from the original study that we did on Om, and so what we were looking at, we had the opportunity to take advantage of the fact that we did a variety of different scans on people, and one of the things that we were able to do is look at just the resting scan, just the baseline scan, whatever term you want to use, but what the brain was just doing when it wasn't doing any particular practice. It was just kind of in its baseline neutral state. And so one of the things that we needed that state in order to see what was going on during the actual practice itself, but we can also then look at that state by itself and try to understand if there are anything. Are there any patterns that we see in the activity of the brain of people who have been doing Om for a long period of time compared to people who have not been doing Om for a long period of time and who just consider to be just otherwise, healthy controls, just people who are non-meditators, so to speak. And we've done this with other studies. We've done this by looking at other kinds of meditation practices, and there's even other colleagues of mine out there who have done these kinds of studies. So, but this, of course, was the first time anybody's ever looked at the brains of people who specifically are doing the orgasmic meditation practice. So what we did was we compared the brains of the people who have done Om for for a number of years to those people who have not. And we see some really interesting differences that in the brain. Now, the one slight piece to this, which is which has always been a little bit of an issue that I have to be clear about, is that we're kind of capturing a snapshot, if you will, of where the person is today. And we did not do a longitudinal study where we took people before they ever started doing Om and then see how it changed them. But what's interesting to me is that when we have looked at both longitudinal studies over time as well as these kind of cross-sectional studies, I think what we've come to learn is that while people may have a certain predisposition to enjoying a particular kind of practice, doing the practice itself clearly has an impact on people, and it does change the brain over time. So when we look at this particular data, when we look at this study, what we found was, as I mentioned, that there are significant differences in the people who have been doing Om for a long period of time compared to those who have not. And what's interesting is that they seem to be in a number of the pattern, the differences seem to be in a number of areas of the brain that we also found were involved when the practice was being done, areas of the brain that support our ability to connect with other people, to feel a sense of oneness and connectedness with another person, to feel a sense of flow with another person. And we can talk about all of these in a little bit of detail in a moment when we look at some of the images. But nonetheless, what I think this ultimately kind of tells us, and we've seen this in some other practices as well, is that part of what happens as you do the practice, you obviously see a change in the moment, but you also see this longer term effect, which to me, I think the best way of kind of understanding it is that it potentiates the ability to have different kinds of experiences, to have these kinds of spiritual experiences. So the practice itself is a thing that you do, is a practice that you're doing, but then there are experiences that arise when you're doing the practice that as you do it more and more, there is a kind of training effect, if you will. There's a change that occurs that enables your brain to be able to engage those experiences more and more. And again, to sort of take it to a more neutral perspective, if you think about, like a Buddhist meditator who might meditate for 20 years before they achieve enlightenment, even though they achieve enlightenment 20 years from now, they needed all those other practices to sort of prime the brain for having that experience. And I think Om, very likely, based on this data, works in a very similar kind of way, that it changes the brain over time, that enables people to have these kinds of powerful experiences that are very spiritual for them.